YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday, the 11th of November. I'm Georgina White. The PDP lineup is presented to the press. Charities push for a ban on smoking in public. It's Armistice Day and the troops are out. Twitter facts. And finally, YGTV is launched with a promise to report the news as you see it. Keith Asobardi and his team sat in front of the press yesterday. Frankie Hatton was there.
The PDP slate was revealed yesterday afternoon amid a flurry of mineral water and smiles. Unlike most political parties, the scent of hair lacquer was in the air, and not from the bouffanted locks of Keith Asopardi, but a bevy of ladies selected by their executive. The team is Keith Asopardi, of course, as leader, along with Nick Cruz, Gigi Sene, Moira Walsh, Elliot Phillips, Rebecca Faller, Dave Everson, Kenneth Navas, Dilip Taylor, and last but not least, Rosemary Peach. Mr. Asopardi was pragmatic about the difficulties that lie ahead, but I asked him what inroads he feels he can make against the GSD and the GSLP.
Well, look, if the big difference between us and the GSD is that they want to be in government and we want them to get out of government. If we did not have a different vision or a different way of doing things or a different offer to put to the people of Gibraltar, we would not be standing as a separate party, nor would they, presumably. We think we have a very distinct vision. I said it before in some of my remarks. There has been progress made between 1988 and 1996, and significant progress made between 1996 and 2011. We now need to take an extra step for progress. We think that we are the party to do it. We think that we take, if you see our manifesto and the key pledges that we are fighting this election on: style of government, better economic management, better opportunities, better services and quality of life, that responds to the agenda that people are concerned about.
Seven of Gibraltar's cancer charities are pushing for a ban on smoking in public places. YGTV spoke to Brian Zammit about Gibraltar's anti-smoking lobbying.
Brian Zammit, you founded and launched the Stop Smoking in Public Places campaign. Today the charities are pushing for a drive for the incoming government, whoever that may be, to do the same thing. What's your thoughts on that today?
I think it's an excellent thing. The cancer charities have actually been on board with us for quite some time now. We did actually meet with the Chief Minister a couple of years back. In fact, Isabella Liu, who's one of the candidates with the GSD, she was one of the persons that came to meet the Chief Minister with me. At the time, he said he wasn't going to pass legislation, but bit by bit, he would introduce more and more bans within the community, which I have to be honest with you, he has done. But it's obviously not good enough. The whole of Europe have gone non-smoking. The States, Canada, have been non-smoking for many, many years as well. It really is about time that it was passed in Gibraltar.
Ryan Zammit, thank you very much indeed.
You're welcome.
It was Armistice Day today, and ahead of the Remembrance Parade on Sunday, the troops are out selling the poppies.
Today is, or rather was, Armistice Day. On this day, more than any other, we wear the poppy as a symbol of remembrance for all our fallen soldiers, sailors and airmen. The words are wrong, of course, because many women too fell fighting for their country. The British Legion sells the poppies and all proceeds go to various charities to help veterans in time of need, whoever and wherever they are. The Remembrance Day Parade itself is on Sunday at the Cross of Sacrifice, and the King's Chapel will obviously be holding a service. Wear your poppy with pride.
11-11-11 is not just YGTV launch day, it is also palindromic. Nicole Macedo has the facts.
I Tweet Facts has reminded us that today's date, 11-11-11, is known to be a palindromical phenomena which only happens once a century. Today's internet news sites are a mess. Spook stories about today's date. The UK's Guardian, for example, claims that today's date has prompted the closure of the Pyramid of Cheops in Egypt, following rumours of a Masonic ritual planned for today. We are all aware that World War I ended on November 11th at 11 a.m, but did you know these other 11-11-11 facts? The last time it was today's date was Saturday, November 11th, 1911, and the next time this palindrome will occur is in 100 years on 2111.
And finally, YGTV launched today. Every weekday from 8 p.m. on our website, you can watch the day's news, and not the news we want, but your news too. Hi, I'm Georgina White, and welcome to YGTV News. To celebrate the launch, we are holding a competition to win an iPad 2 for Christmas. All you have to do is go to the site and be one of the first 2,000 people who register. It's free, so go to it. We want photos, ideas, and even local stories to keep us reporting the world you see. Go to www.yourgibraltartv.com for the stories, the competitions, and the news. Thank you for watching YGTV. I'm back on Monday. See you then.